Hey everyone, and welcome to the channel. Today we're going to be talking about how to buy and sell on the Robinhood app. Now, this is somewhat of a beginner's tutorial, but if you've been using the app for just a little bit of time, this can maybe still help you out. Some of the things we're going to be talking about today are the mistakes that I made that I don't want you to make as well, because it can cost you some really good money. Now, I was actually only utilizing a little bit of money back and forth before I realized the mistake that I was making when it came to buying and selling in the market in general. So what we're gonna do is talk about how you should actually be buying and selling on the Robinhood app. All right, so what we're gonna do now is actually load up the screen here of Robinhood so I can go through the process and show you exactly how this all goes through. Now, for some people, if you just wanna buy a share into a company, you're just gonna go in and purchase things in what they call real time, and that is going to actually cost you money. And that's what I want to stop you from doing, because if you do that when you buy and sell your stocks, you are going to be losing out on some good chunk of change. And as you get better at investing, that can eat up more and more of your money, and I don't want that to happen to you. So make sure you're following along here. Also too, if you have any questions on the Robinhood app, let me know in the comments down below. I'll either answer them or even potentially make a future video for it. So what we're gonna do now is actually go through the process of buying a share of a company. I'm just gonna do it as an example, of course. So we're gonna look into Ford here. Now, what a lot of people do, they'll just go ahead and click on the trade button and they'll click on buy. Now over here, if you wanna buy a share of Ford, you're just gonna put the number one, and then it's gonna say that it's 864. Now you can see towards the kind of left-hand side there, it says estimated cost is going to be 864. Because what happens is when I hit review and then actually do the full trade, it might actually cost me more based off of how the market is moving, and that can be quite a bit of money for me. Now, one share is not gonna do the most, but if I was buying 10, 20, 30 shares, it can start eating away at the money that I am trying to make from this. Because of course, with investing, you wanna be trying to make some good money. Now, what we want to do instead of actually buying at the real-time market, we want to actually hit where it says order type, which is on the top right-hand corner. So we're going to go ahead and hit order type. Now, here's the great thing is if you've actually gone through this process before, it's going to be very similar from other platforms. But if you haven't, this is what we're going to kind of go over and give you an idea of what we want to do. So we're going to go into where it says a market order. And here it actually gives you a quick example and a nice little chart there that moves. And it says buy Ford at the best price currently available on the market. Keep in mind, the final execution price might be different from the market price displayed in the app. And again, that's kind of where a lot of people tend to lose a little bit of money here and there, because if they are expecting to spend, you know, $8.64, but it actually comes out to $8.70 per share, that's going to start really eating away, especially if you're trying to make sure that you're getting the best price possible. So next we wanna go to the other options that they have available for us. And this right here is a limit order. So a limit order says set the limit price or the maximum price at which you are willing to buy Ford. Your order will only be executed at the limited price or lower. So that is a good option if you want to do, you know, what they call dollar cost average. So if you already have stock in a company and you don't want to overpay for it and only buy more when it hits down at a certain price point, this is a great option for a lot of people. But you can see here on that little graph, it has the stock price is kind of moving up and down, and then maybe it has like a bad day, you know, bad earnings call, and then it goes under the limit price, and that's when it ends up buying into the shares of the company. So with Ford, if I said, hey, I want to dollar cost average, maybe go down to 850, I can limit the order to 850, and if it ever goes down that low, then it will automatically do a purchase for me. Now, the next option is going to be a stop order. So a stop order says set a fixed stop price above the current price of Ford. A market buy order is triggered when Ford raises to the stop price or higher. So this is the one where if you see the price being at 864 like it currently is and you want to buy it no more than 865, you can put 865, and then that way it is triggered when it gets to that price point, and that's what you buy it at altogether. So you can see in that graph there that the, you know, the stock is up and down, up and down, and then it gets to that point where it's actually valued at where you want it to be. That's when it actually pulls the trigger for you. So if you don't own any stock in that company, that is usually a good option for you if you wanted to make sure that you're not overpaying, you know, based off of the maybe changes in the market just by the time you review it and actually submit the offer into the actual app. Now, before we continue on with the video, let me know if you are getting value out of this content by hitting that like button down below. That lets me know that you guys want me to make more of this type of video content. And if not, I'll just go ahead and put it to the wayside and continuing making other types of content for you. So next up is going to be the stop limit order. So this one is set a fixed price above the current price of Ford. A limit buy order is triggered when Ford rises to the stop price or higher. So the way this one works, as you can see on the chart here, and this really helps out a lot because of the chart, you'll see the stock price kind of go down and then up, and then you'll see that spot where it says stop price, and then the stock, you know, just plummets back down. When it hits that plummet down, then it ends up doing an actual purchase in the market. So you could do this for a couple different reasons. Maybe a company is going up and down kind of a little bit. So you say, hey, if they reach a certain height and then they drop to a certain low, then I want to buy for, you know, whatever reason. Maybe you believe in the company, but you have a feeling maybe this quarter is not going to do well. Whatever the case may be, that is an option for you there. And then the next one right over here, this is going to be the trailing stop order. So this one says the stop price follows or trails the lowest price of Ford by trailing that you set. A market buy is triggered when Ford rises to the stop price or higher. So again, like you kind of saw there, you can see the market going up and down, and based off of where you set it to go, then it'll automatically trigger after it hits a certain trailing point. So this might be an option for somebody who kind of wants to follow the market and buy in maybe at a good time. But this is just another option available for you. So I personally like to do a stop order when it comes to actually placing an order. I like to make sure that, you know, I'm actually buying at the price point I'm expecting to pay for. If I'm trying to dollar cost average, then I would kind of go along the lines of a limit order where I would, again, put it down where if the market price goes down on that fund, I would actually end up buying it. Because as an example with Ford here, I have 9 shares at 862. So as of right now, if I purchase into it, I'm actually increasing my dollar cost average versus if I actually put the that order in through to say I only want to buy at 862 or maybe 850 in case that actual fund goes down, then I'm lowering my dollar cost average. And you also can do the same thing here in the sell category as well. So if you're wanting to sell, you can do the real time, but that's going to cost you. Or if you go into the order types, you can go through all those exact same ones. Now, if you're going through the process of, you know, wanting to sell and you make that decision, you can actually even ask them to stop showing this if you don't want it to have constantly popping up on you. I just wanted to kind of save that part so that way I can show you guys the differences when it comes to all the different order types, because I think it's important to know so that way you can get the most value out of your money. So that way you can actually invest more of it and then have more for your own future. So all that compounding is going to go a very long way. All right, so as I was going through and editing this video, unfortunately part of the video did not get recorded on my phone. So I had to go through this whole process again. I threw the same shirt back on. So hopefully it all looks very similar for you. But what I really needed to show you as well too is the last portion after going through and deciding on which order type you want to go through. So if we hit continue from, let's say, a stop order, what you're going to see next is the option to put in a price for you. So for this one, it obviously says trigger a market buy if Ford rises to a certain price point. So we're going to say, let's say 865, and we hit continue. Now the next thing it's going to ask you is says set time in force. Now this is really important too, because you want to make sure you have the best available time frame for what you want. And right here it says if the order doesn't execute, it should expire by what time. You could have it expire by the end of market time, which is 1 p.m. my time here in Arizona. Or what you can do is you can have it go up until 90 days. So that would be January 29th, 2020, as of this recording at least. So whenever you do that market order, you get to choose, do you wanna have it just for that day, or do you want it to go indefinitely for the next 90 days in case that price fluctuates in the market, and then it triggers that buy or the sell, depending on how and when you choose to go through with that. So all that to say, make sure that you choose the right option for you when it comes to the order type, how long you want it, whether you want it for just the day or the 90 days to actually go through. And so that way you are getting the most effective price point that you want when it comes to the funds you want to purchase. So of course, as I mentioned, this also applies to when you want to sell your stock as well. So whether you want to go with a limit order or you want to go with a stop order, it's essentially just in reverse at that point for you when you want to get the right price point for the stock if you're in a selling mode. Now, depending on the type of investor you are, you should typically be trying to go for the long haul and try to invest for the future and not in short terms, because of course that can be pretty dangerous when it comes to investing on Robinhood. Robinhood if you're not very well experienced. Now, of course, if you are following along with these order types and making sure that you're really paying attention to how you're purchasing and selling your stocks, this can really benefit you in the long haul when it comes to making sure that you're keeping as much of your money as possible by still getting a good deal and getting into the funds that you want to buy, whether it's individual stocks or ETFs on Robinhood. So that is how you buy and sell on Robinhood, so that way you can get the most value out of your money. If you want to keep on learning more about Robinhood, check out my videos right over here, so that way you can keep on learning and growing your investments. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.